بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The book we're going to be starting today, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, is a very important book. Whenever you start a book, it's not just about the book, but the author of the book. And the author of this particular book is Sheikh Abdul Razak Al-Badr, who was one of the teachers in Al-Masjid Al-Nabawi, the Prophet's Mosque in Medina. Sheikh Abdul Razak Al-Badr, hafidhahullah ta'ala, is also a professor in the Islamic University of Medina. And likewise, his father, Sheikh Abdul Muhsin Abbad, is one of the greatest scholars of our time today in Hadith. Sheikh Abdul Muhsin Al-Abbad, hafidhahullahu ta'ala. So it's a scholarly family. And this book we're going to look at today, insha'Allah ta'ala, from the first chapter of the book, we'll see the importance of this book. The title of this book is Fiqh Al-Asmaaual Husna, the understanding and the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beautiful name. And the importance of this book is, as Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala said, man arafa Allah bi asma'ihi wa sifatihi ahabba Allah la mahala. That whoever truly knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his names, by his attributes, would definitely, certainly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without a choice in the matter. So the Shaykh, rahimahullah ta'ala, he began the first chapter with the topic, Bab Fadl Ilm Asma'illahi wa Sifatihi. The chapter or manzila, or the high station, or the lofty position of knowledge of Allah's names and His attributes. And the Shaykh, rahimahullah ta'ala, hafidhahullah, he began by saying that this particular topic, or this particular subject, is Babun Sharifu min al-ilm, is the most honorable topic or subject or chapter of knowledge, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His beautiful names and His attributes. And he went on to say, Bal huwa al-fiqh al-akbar. This is al-fiqh al-akbar. There's no greater knowledge, there's no greater understanding than to know Allah by His names and attributes. That when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ, that whoever Allah wants good for, wills good for, what does Allah give that person? يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. It gives him fiqh, understanding of the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that it gives whoever wants good for, understanding of the religion, that knowing Allah's names and attributes, it comes as what? The first in order of all these things. That if Allah wants good for you, that the greatest priority is for you to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His names and attributes. And the question is, why? Why? The reason is, 17 times a day at least, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what? Ihdina siratan mustaqim. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the straight path. And that straight path you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you to is for you to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His names and His attributes. Because when Allah ta'ala said, وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ, those who compete against each other, this is what they should compete for. That the aim, the objective, the end goal of everyone that strives to attain good is what? To know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because huwa imad as-sayr ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is your main path, the main highway, the fundamental route to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His names and attributes. Because as the Shaykh, hafidhahullah ta'ala, mentioned, مَا مِن بِنَاءٍ إِلَّا وَلَهُ أَسَاسٍ. There is no structure, there is no building, except it has what? It has a foundation. وَعِمَادُ هَذَا الدِّينِ or أَسَاسُ هَذَا الدِّينِ. And the foundation of this religion is what? Al-Imanu Billahi, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the foundation of the religion. And how do you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? بِأَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ, by Allah's names and attributes. And the mushrikeen, the polytheists, in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they knew this. That's why when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with his message, what was the thing they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? They say, Ya Muhammad, sif lana rabbak. Describe to us, tell us who is your Lord. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the ayah mentioning his names and attributes. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. So this is the foundation of the religion. And if we do not build upon this foundation, whatever structure we have in our lives as Muslims will become what? Weak. And that's why Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala said, مَنْ أَرَادَ عُلُوَ بُنْيَانِهِ. Whoever wants is found is building or is structure to be elevated and to rise, فَعَلَيْهِ بِثَوْثِيقِهِ, is upon him, is obligatory upon him to strengthen his foundation. Because the stronger a foundation of a building is, the higher you could raise that building. So if you have an intention to build a 10-story building, it has to be according to the what? The foundation. So if your intention is to reach higher goals and reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the foundation has to be what? It has to be solid. So Ibn Qayyim said, Man arada, if you wish to raise in levels, in position and in rank, strengthen that foundation. And the foundation is what? Faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, true his names and in his attributes. And any building and any structure that suffers from destruction or suffers from collapse is repairable, so long as the what is solid? The foundation. But if the foundation is weak or is collapsed, the whole building collapses. And that's why Al-Arif, the one that truly is aware, truly is conscious, what does he do? He focuses on what? Strengthening his foundation. Many a times we have classes, we have reminders. In this age of TikTok, age of YouTube, people want what they call iman boosters. A quick fizz, 3-second video, quick reminder. But yet we find, we keep going back to the same habits. And we're not improving. And why is this? It's like the example of a person. It builds the most beautiful structure. Nice doors, nice windows. Interior, superb, but the foundation is what? It's weak. So this foundation is very, very important if we're conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to us in the Quran, that أَفَمَنْ أَسَّسَ بُنْيَانَهُ عَلَىٰ تَقْوَى مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking, is the one, or who is actually better? مَنْ أَسَّسَ بُنْيَانَهُ عَلَىٰ تَقْوَى مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانٍ خَيْرٌ. Who is better? The one that establishes his foundation upon fear of Allah, upon the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is he better? أَمَّنْ أَسَّسَ بُنْيَانَهُ, or the one who establishes his foundation upon what? عَلَىٰ شَافْ جُرُفٍ هَارٍ, that establishes his foundation upon the edge of a cliff which is crumbling, فَنْهَارَ بِهِ, and he crumbles and throws him into the hellfire. So if we don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his names and attributes, and we're learning, whatever we're learning is as though we're establishing our foundation on a what? On the edge of a crumbling cliff. And the foundation of this deen is two things. Number one, knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, surrendering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And because the foundation of this deen is to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you read the Quran, seldom would you find an ayah, except it ends with what? Either one of the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or what else? One of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You'll not find an ayah in the Quran except it ends either with the name of Allah or the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the reason this is because knowing Allah by His names and attributes is connected to that which we were created for. And what is the purpose of our creation? What's the purpose of our creation? To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the purpose of creation. In other words, when we say to worship Allah how? Allah ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. When we say we're created to worship Allah, that's not enough. We're created to worship Allah. Huh? La. When Allah says He's not created the jinn and mankind except to worship Me, what does it mean to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To worship Allah alone. Because anybody that worships Allah and other than Allah has not worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anybody that worships Allah and other with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not worshipped Allah. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man amila amalan, whoever does a deed, ashraka ma'iya ghayri, and he associate partners of Allah in that action, taraktuhu wa shirka, I abandon him and his worship. No, I abandon him and his shirk. So the purpose of worship is tawheed, to worship Allah. And tawheed is two. Tawheed al-ma'rifa wal-ithbat, the tawheed of awareness and affirming Allah's attributes. And tawheed what? Tawheed of deeds, actions and intent, which is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is connected to the worship of Allah azza wa jal. And that's why you find in many ayahs in the Quran, that in the same way Allah ta'ala ordered us, not just to believe la ilaha illallah, because you have many Muslims when giving da'wah, they say the most important thing, we have to give the kalima, brother. We have to give the kalima. People have to know the kalima. They have to know la ilaha illallah. They have to say the kalima. The issue is not just to say the kalima. Because saying la ilaha illallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever dies upon la ilaha illallah enters Jannah. If their last word is la ilaha illallah. But is that all to say it? Is that the only condition? What is the most important condition? Knowledge of la ilaha illallah. It's not just to say it. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَعْلَمْ know أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Don't just believe, know for certain, there's no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. And ask Allah for forgiveness of your sins and for the believing men, believing women. Meaning, before any statement, any action, knowledge must what? Must precede. So in the same way Allah has ordered to know there's no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has also commanded us in many ayats in the Quran to know His names and attributes. أَلَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ بَلَى. From those examples, the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. That have knowledge and know that Allah ta'ala is full of might and is wise. That's a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For you to know, He, Allah, is Azizun Hakim. You have to know the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His attributes. Allah ta'ala says, وَعَلَّمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. Have knowledge, know. Allah بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything with what? With knowledge. وَعِلْمُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى الْعَزَلِ الْأَبَدِي. That knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is previous and continuous forever. Meaning Allah Ta'ala, He encompasses everything with knowledge. How? عَلِمَ مَا كَانَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows every single thing that was. وَعَلِمَ مَا سَيَكُونَ. And Allah knows every single thing that is going to be. وَإِن لَمْ يَكُونَ. And even if that thing never came to pass, or it never happened. In kana, if it was to happen, alima kaifa sayakun. He knows exactly how it happened. Subhanallah. Wa indahu mafatihul ghayb la ya'lamuha illa hu. With Allah Ta'ala is the keys of the unseen. No one knows it but Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And that knowledge of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, Allah Ta'ala says, ya'lamu ma fil barri wal bahr. Allah Ta'ala, He knows every single thing on the face of the earth and in the oceans. مَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ Not a single leaf drops in any part of the world or on the earth except Allah knows it. Subhanallah. Not a single leaf. وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ. There's not a single seed in the deepest part of the earth except Allah Ta'ala knows it. Allah Ta'ala says, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ حَلِيمٌ. Know Allah is forgiven. Not just believe, and He is forbearing. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ. Though Allah Ta'ala is self-sufficient and full of praise. And many other ayats you find like this, that Allah Ta'ala commands us to know Him by His names and attributes. There are too many. And there's so many that the author, Hafidhahullah Ta'ala, he says, أَمَّا ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ لِأَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ فِي الْقُرْآنِ فَوَكَثِيرٌ جِدًّا. There are so many, he said, there's so many of them that they're innumerable. That Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala said, وَالْقُرْآنُ فِيهِ مِنْ ذِكْرِ أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ وَأَفْعَالِهِ أَكْثَرُ مِمَّا فِيهِ مِنْ ذِكْرِ الْأَكْلِ وَالشُّرْبِ وَالنِّكَاحِ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. That Allah Ta'ala's mentioning of His names and attributes and His actions are more in the Quran than the mentioning of eating and drinking and marriage in Jannah. And he went on to say, والآيات المتضمنة لذكر أسماء الله وصفاته أعظم قدرا من آيات الميعاد. That the verses in the Quran that mentions Allah's names and attributes, they're greater in weight, not in number, in weight than ayats that speak about the hereafter. There's a great difference between something being greater in number and greater in what? In weight, on the scales. And he mentioned an example of this. And that's a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to show the weight of Allah's names and attributes. That once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked Ubay ibn Ka'ab, ما أعظم آية في كتاب الله. What is the greatest verse in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And I asked, not the older brothers, the younger brothers, what is the greatest? Yes, Salman. Salman is here, right? Yes, Salman. What is the greatest verse in the Quran? Salman, mashallah. I know he knows. One of our top students, mashallah. Na'am. Jazakallah khairan. Ayatul Kursi. And what is Ayatul Kursi about? Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. Describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in terms of qadr, weight, the ayahs of the sifat are great. What is the greatest chapter in the Quran? Not the longest surah, the greatest chapter in weight. La. Jazakallah khairan. MashaAllah. Surah Al-Fatiha. And if you look at Fatiha, there's more mentioning and describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the hereafter. And there's another one, another surah, which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, due to this surah, he told the sahabi, أَحَبَّكَ اللَّهُ لِحُبِّكَ إِيَّاهَا. Allah has loved you because you love this surah. There's a sahaba radiallahu anhum, the other sahaba went to complain that every single salah, he read the same surah after Fatiha, same surah. And he said, I love this surah, لِأَنَّ فِيهَا صِفَةُ رَبْ. I love this surah because it has, it's describing my Lord. And he read it all the time. And he told him, Allah loves you because you love this surah. And this surah, ثُلُثُ الْقُرْآنِ. Look at the weight of this surah. It is a third of the Quran. Meaning if you read this surah three times, it's like though you read the whole Quran. Which surah is this? Ikhlas. Jazakallah khairan. Surah Al-Ikhlas. To show those ayats that speak about attribute of Allah Azza wa Jal, أَعْظَمُ قَدَرًا. They're greater in terms of weight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Shaykh went on to mention that وَهَذَا وَاضِحُ الدَّلَالَةِ. This is a clear proof, a clear evidence عَلَى أَهْمِيَةِ هَذَا الْعِلْمِ الشَّرِيفِ. A clear proof of the importance of this knowledge and the goodness of it. And not only the goodness of it, وَهُوَ أَصْلٌ مِنْ أُصُولِ الْإِيمَانِ. It is a foundation from the foundations of Iman, faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the reasons we chose this book. To build a solid foundation. For ourselves, for our children, for our wives. That true knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through his names and attributes, it will reflect bi'idhnillahi ta'ala in our action. That Allah sees us, Allah knows us, Allah is aware. Even in our dua, it will have an effect. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. To Allah belongs the most beautiful names. فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا. That if when you're calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, somebody oppresses you and you know Allah by his names and attributes. If you know Allah Azza wa Jalla, what you say? Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, قَدْ ظَلَمِنَ هَذَا الرَّجُلُ. Oh Allah, the most merciful, this person's oppressed me. Would this be in context? Ya Aziz, Ya Jabbar, Ya Muntaqim. That would be in context. You're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide for you. They say, Ya Allah, Ya Aziz, Ya Jabbar. What would you say? Ya Razaq. That aslu min usul al-Iman, a fundamental part of Iman in Allah Azza wa Jalla. And it's important to build upon these fundamentals. Of course, people will say, we want heart softeners, we want things to fizz our Iman. If you truly understand these things, there's nothing that softens the heart more, that brings you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more, than knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his names and attributes. And he went on to say, رُكْنُ مِنْ أَرْكَانِ الدِّينِ. It is a pillar from the pillars of the religion. وَأَسَاسٌ مِنْ أُسُسِ مِلَّةِ الْإِسْلَامِ. And it is a fundamental from the fundamentals of Islam. And he went on to ask the Sheikh حَفِظَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى that كَيْفَ يَسْتَقِيمُ أَمْرُ الْبَشَرِيَّةِ. How could the affairs of mankind be put straight, all the Muslims generally, and the affairs sorted out without them knowing their creator, without them knowing the one that fashioned them, وَخَالِقُهُمْ, the one that created them, وَرَازِقُهُمْ, and the one that provided for them. How would the affairs be in order? Without knowing his beautiful names and his high attributes, that denotes perfection, and that no one deserves therefore to be worshipped in truth except for Allah Azza wa Jalla. But the problem, he said, وَلَكِنْ أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ شَغَلَهُمْ مَا خُلِقُ لَهُمْ عَمَّا خُلِقُوا لَهُ. The majority of people, they have become preoccupied with what was created for them from what they were created for. Most of us were so preoccupied with what was created for us. What was created for us? Wealth, dunya. We're so preoccupied with dunya that as you're sitting there, barakallahu ta'ala feekum, that this is not an extracurricular activity. This is not something I just do, it's a voluntary thing. No, knowledge is obligatory upon every single Muslim, and knowing Allah Azza wa Jal. But unfortunately, especially with our main aims and objectives here, that most of us, we are expats in this land, meaning we came here to work. But primarily, we came into this dunya to do what? To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you cannot worship Allah upon ignorance. Whether it's this class, whether it's other class, whether it's online, it should be a priority to build your life around the ilm. In the same way, it is a priority you build your life around salah. You should have a body clock. And it's a check. You should check yourselves. How much am I seeking knowledge? How much am I reading the Quran? And everything else, your work schedule, or it's a Friday today, I have to go out with my family, Saturday, holidays, everything has to be built around what? Hawl al-ilm. He said, unfortunately, this is the state of many other people today, that they're so busy what's created for them from that which they were created for. So your whole life has to circle around this, worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in that, you truly find happiness. And not pleasure. Because there's a difference between pleasure and happiness. Pleasure you feel immediately, you feel in your body. And it doesn't go above your neck. But true happiness is through this. And he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, حَبَّرَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عِبَادَهُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ بِقَوْلِ. Allah ta'ala has warned his slaves from this. Now don't become preoccupied what you're created or what was created for you from that which you're created for. Allah Ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O you believe, لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله. O you believe, do not cause your wealth or your children to divert you from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether it is them directly or indirectly. Directly, you're preoccupied with your children, or indirectly, you're preoccupied with providing for your children. Do not let that take you away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَالرَّزَاقُ ذُو قُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Know that all the time. Then Allah Ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَٰلِكَ. Whoever does so, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. These are indeed the true losers. وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ. The next chapter, inshaAllah Ta'ala, which we'll go to next week, بإذن الله تعالى, فَضْلُ الْعِلْمِ بِأَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَصِفَاتِهِ. The excellence, subhanAllah, a very important chapter, of knowing Allah by His names and attributes, and also the chapter فَضْلُ الْعِلْمِ بِأَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى again وَأَسْمَائِهِ. Continuing the excellence of knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His names and attributes. InshaAllah, we stop here. And as I did in one of the previous classes, I'll ask the brother, the length of the class usually, maybe 20 minutes, 30 minutes after Jumu'ah, people still have somewhere to go, and it's a day off. And if the brothers, they want it to be longer, usually the class is about 40 minutes. Anything after 40 minutes, people's attention disappears. So we could keep it at this length, 25 minutes, 30 minutes, or 40 minutes. So, Ya Abu Abdurrahman, 30 minutes? 40 minutes? 40? Huh? Huh? Okay. Some say 40, some say 30. So inshallah ta'ala, we'll go the middle path. Half an hour, bi-ibnillah ta'ala. Are there any questions, inshallah? No question. Huh? Naam. Naam.
Some verses like Alam Tara Kaifa Fa'ala Rabbuka Bi Ashabi Al-Fil.
You know, so I said there's not a verse except, hardly would you find a verse in the Quran except it what? It ends with either the name or attributes of Allah. Yeah, not every single verse. Hardly would you find. Meaning okay. A lot of verses okay. In the Quran. Now. Not every single verse.
Exactly.
Except you find that. And another important thing, which is a good question, is that in speech, or even the Quran, sometimes there's something called metaphors, or something called isti'ara, that you mention the whole of something, but because it's like the majority, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the people of Nuh when he came to the da'wah, جَعَلُوا أَصَابِعَهُمْ فِي آذَانِهِمْ. They stuck their fingers in their ears, but they didn't stick their fingers in their ears, but due to the extent of it. So sometimes you might find the kalam of the ulama that kullun, everyone, but it means the majority. And that's why there's a principle in fiqh which is al-ghalibu kal-kull. The majority is like the whole. So if you're working in a place or in a situation that 99% of what you're doing is halal, but there's some doubtful matters there, you judge by the what? The majority. Now.
Jazakumullahu khayr. Now, my question is some people, they are bearing the names of Allah, like Rahman, Rahim. So some people, they attach, of course, it's important to have Abdul, so all the names of Allah. But is there any kind of punishment or kind of sin, let me say so to say, for those people who doesn't attach Abdurrahman, like Abdul, to the names of Allah?
Jazakallah khair. Very good question. Said, when it comes to the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we know people attach things to it. Like, and I mention again, make sure it's from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because there's some things that's not from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we'll learn later on, that there's a difference between a name and a what? An attribute. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has certain attributes, but they're not His what? They're not His names. So every name is an attribute, but not every attribute is a what? Is a name. So if it's definite from the names of Allah ta'ala, the brother's asking, some people sometimes attach Abd, for example, Rahim, Abdurrahim. And some people, they'll not attach Abd. They'll say Rahim or Hamid. There's certain names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, or attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we're not the same with Allah in it, but we share the names or the attributes. For example, Allah ta'ala, Aleem. Human being likewise is what? Aleem. But it's not like Allah ta'ala. Allah ta'ala, Sami'un, Basirun. We're also Sami'an, Basirun. Jayid. So now, if my name is Rahim, do I have to say Abdul Rahim? Of course, it's better. But the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which are not specifically for Allah azza wa jal, a person be called Rahim, wa Abdul Rahim. Like the hadith, Ar-Rahimun, those who are Rahimun, Allah has mercy upon them. A person called Hamid, wa Abdul Hamid. But the names which are only for Allah, you have to have Abd in front of it. Such as Ar-Rahman. Somebody could not be called Rahman. It has to be Abdul Rahman. Also, if a person's name is Abdul Rahim, Abdul Rahman, is not put to just to Abd. Abd. Abd of what? Slave of who? Servant of what? Or as some people call it short, they'll say Abdi. Abdi in certain cultures, the Somali culture. And grammatically, what does Abdi mean? It means my slave. Now, barakallahu fi. You know, some people have different ways they shorten things. For example, Ubaidullah. Some people say Ubaidi. What does Ubaidi mean? It means my slave. Because Ubaid is the making something smaller. Like you have Umar, you have Umayr, small Umar. Abd, Ubaid, small Abd. Okay? So this is to make something smaller. You have Jund, an army. And you have a smaller army, which is what? Junaid. Now, we stop here, inshallah ta'ala. Subhanakallah, bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta.